From the moment COVID-19 began to spread, there were questions about its origin. This week, there have been reports U.S. diplomats are concerned about a lab in Wuhan, China, the city where the outbreak began. Nick Schifrin examines what the U.S. knows and doesn't know about how coronavirus originally spread.
Today in Wuhan, the markets sell live animals. The shopkeepers insist their product is clean and had nothing to do with the COVID-19 outbreak. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo seemed to agree with the shopkeepers and raised on Fox News last night another source.
We know that this virus originated in Wuhan, China. We know that there is the Wuhan Institute of Virology just a handful of miles away from where the wet market was. There's still lots to learn.
The Wuhan Institute of Virology's website includes these photos showing off its technology. U.S. officials tell PBS NewsHour they've long been concerned about lab security, and they consider the possibility that COVID-19 was accidentally released by a lab employee who was working with animals that carry coronaviruses.
More and more we're hearing the story. We are doing a very thorough examination of this horrible situation.
But the intelligence community has not concluded for sure that's what happened. U.S. officials tell PBS NewsHour it's still possible the market was the source.
The results are inconclusive, if you will.
We've had a lot of intelligence. Take a hard look at that. And I would just say at this point, it's inconclusive.
Last month, China's Ministry of Foreign Affairs blamed the U.S. military for spreading the virus. Chinese media have even blamed Italy. Today, spokesman Zhao Lijian said it's too early to know the source, but denied it was the lab.
This is a scientific issue which should be studied by scientists and medical experts. Many well-known medical experts in the world also believe that claims of the so-called laboratory leaks have no scientific basis.
And for more on this, we turn to Dr. Luciana Borio. She served on the National Security Council staff as the Director of Medical and Biodefense Preparedness Policy during the first 2 years of the Trump administration. She's now a vice president at InQtel, a nonprofit that funds technologies the intelligence community is interested. Dr. Borio, thank you very much. Welcome to the NewsHour. Those two scenarios I just laid out, some kind of accidental release from a lab in Wuhan and a possible release in the nearby wet market, are either of those still possible?
That's right, Nick. So the national biodefense strategy that was signed by President Trump in 2018 contemplates, you know, three general categories of biological threats: the deliberate threats, an accident from a lab exposure or release, and naturally occurring exposure. We don't believe that this strain has any features that it was a deliberate event at all. Really, so it's a natural strain. Now, the question about whether the original human exposure that led to the pandemic initially occurred in a laboratory setting or a wet market or something like that is going to be very difficult to ascertain. And we don't know.
How would you? Sorry to interrupt you. How would you ascertain that if it is so difficult? What information would you need?
That's right. So it may not be possible just through the scientific means and analysis of the strain. It may need some other type of investigation that is being undertaken by the intelligence community to see what other information may have been available with respect to communications, for example, around that time. But it may be very difficult. And we know that biological threats in general can be very difficult to attribute in a potential source. But, you know, there's, again, either way, what we have to remember today is that we have a pandemic in our hands. And the most important thing to focus on right now is to contain it. There will be a time when we're going to be able to go back and say, you know, what happened? And I have to say that there's more to do globally to minimize human exposure to wildlife in those wet markets, because clearly they pose a threat to our security. And there's also more that we have to do to be able to make sure that experimentations with pathogens of pandemic potential, like coronaviruses, are done in a way that meet very stringent biological safety standards.
So obviously there have been questions by U.S. officials about the safety standards within these labs, as well as concerns that China isn't closing the wet markets. Also among the U.S. concerns is the original virus, the original genome. When it comes to actually finding out what happened, how important is it that China share information that it has from patients, presumably from as early as December?
Yeah, so the more information scientists have, the more they'll be able to understand this virus. There was a lot of work that was done early on when a sequence was posed. They allowed the development of diagnostic tests. Having the virus itself in the right hands, in the right labs, can also facilitate product development. So it's very critical to share information about something that really impacts the entire world, right? Impacts everybody. And we need to be able to work together to be able to contain it.
And lastly, in the 30 seconds or so we have left, your last point, we have to work together to contain it. I mean, how important is it at the end of the day to actually know the origin of COVID-19?
The most important thing that we have to do is to be able to save lives and restore our economic security and our health security. So that's going to be the most important thing. We can't lose focus of that. We may or may not be able to ascertain the origins. And the important thing is that we contain this.
Dr. Luciana Borio, thank you very much.
My pleasure.